You have to do it the way you like it, as it does to do it and have it screwed up. I mean, you know, some of the things that money has. Exactly right.
I'm not sure.
I'm real bad on that.
Yeah.
Some things I'm know what I want.
Either they're making the print smaller.
Paint colors always kind of.
That's like right now, I need a new car. I don't know what I want.
I just got at least a Nissan Leaf electric car. You gotta see it. No gas. I still got my truck, but this thing is a $5,000 state of Georgia tax credit. My lease for 2 years is about $7,000. So it's with no gas.
The state's gonna pay for it.
It's about free. No, it is, because the girl's office run around town in it too, and I'm not paying their gas. So it's, I'm making money on this. Little white thing. Parking my driveway.
I did see that. I thought you had a car.
No, I plug it in at night at the house.
Okay, cool.
And they should be working on that.
Y'all been busy? It'd go 90 miles. But it only go 100 miles without charge. A charge. But for you, winding back? I'm telling you, man, it's not. You take it out. But you don't want to buy it. They're selling like 20 a day. Georgia's number one state. They're going to change the law.
Yeah.
No, you lease it, you get the credit.
I call the meeting to order. Let the record reflect all council members are present, with the exception of Ms. Mount. Before we get into the department reports, I'd like Chief Glass to stand up. I just want to personally thank you on behalf of council of bringing or showing everybody what a good city we have, what a great police department we have, and we just appreciate you and are very proud of being nominated the president of the Georgia Association of Police Chiefs.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you, and this is an honor to get to have that kind of leadership opportunity, and I certainly couldn't do it without you, Mr. Mayor, and the council, and the support you give me, and Mr. Chancellor gives me, but it was a humbling thing. I got sworn in on my grandfather's Bible. It was a great experience for me, and I thank y'all for that opportunity.
Well, we certainly appreciate it. Now we'll move into the department reports, starting with code.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Just the highlights of the report covering the month of June. We had a total of 478 calls, 57 code inspections we had. Permits are going up, but we had 67 permits written that month. And we had 12 renewals or new business licenses for that month as well. City Marshal wrote 194 repair cleanup orders in June and his re-inspections, and he investigated 4 tampering and theft cases, wrote 2 citations, continued to represent the city and municipal court. The remainder of the report is there for your perusal, and any questions you have, I'll try and answer them.
Any questions for Patrick? Thank you.
Sir.
Electric and telecom.
Yes, sir. Used a little over 13.5 million kilowatt hours, total cost of $1.1 million. That will be going down for next month. We're experiencing a very cool summer, as y'all are seeing. A top user of 829 gig and 211 above 200. Our peak usage is up to 1.4. We did implement our second gig of internet. It is basically in place, providing internet to our fiber customers right now, and we are putting all the cable customers on to the first gig, and we will be slowly transitioning that over here shortly. But it's actually worked out good for us.
Mr. Thompson, would you explain what you just said?
Yes, sir. We have a total backhaul to the internet. We have a pipe to the internet that is 2 gigabits per second. And that is the total for the whole city. We had a pipe of 1 gigabit, we were filling that up. So what we did is we expanded that to 2. We transitioned all of our fiber customers to use the second gig, and those are just customers like Hitachi, some of the cell sites we serve. They're on the second gig, or they're utilizing the second gig, or can utilize the second gig. The first gig we are utilizing by all our cable customers. Now, during the next couple of months, we will be transitioning that to where basically everybody's using both. And we'll probably get to 1.6, 1.7 at that point. We'll be looking for the next gig of internet as we move forward. It's actually a good problem as you get more customers, you need more bandwidth, but we're seeing a lot more bandwidth intensive usage by our customers. Netflix, Hulu, any kind of streaming service that people are using. A lot of people are streaming. You'll notice a lot of the ads for smart homes with security cameras in place. A lot of people are streaming those security cameras back. So that's a lot of that type of technology is changing to be more bandwidth intensive. So we're having to keep our bandwidth up. Now, we actually got a great price on this. It was cheaper than our last gig bit. So we're getting good prices and we're keeping the cost down, but we're going to continue to see more and more bandwidth purchases.
So as we need more, is it just a matter of paying for it? I mean, is it?
It's just a connection. It's just a
no installation stuff. I mean, it's just
a little bit of installation up at 56 Marietta. Nothing really. I mean, we had to buy a new card for our switch and had to make a transition with Cogent, our provider, from a 1 gig to a 10 gig pipe. So now we're set up to buy 10 gig from Cogent. So until we get there, there's really no more change in the hardware.
Good. Thank you.
A couple of things of interest. When I wrote this, I thought we'd be complete with the Jackson Street part of the McDaniel project. We will finish that up this week. We completed the design of the Davis and Lacey Street reconductor. There is an item on the agenda that goes with this. Basically, just to let y'all know where this is going to encompass, it's going to go from Church Street over to the VFW. And I'll get a little more in detail when we get to that on the agenda. We worked on the South Broad T with the engineer. We will actually start construction on our part on that hopefully next week. All the material is here to move the power line. We're going to start on the south side and move north, working with the residents and the businesses in the area to try to limit the traffic issues. And we want to be out of the way when Vertical Earth is ready to come in and do their work. And so we're going to try to get started a little bit earlier than they are. And we started a fiber mapping project. We're installing the switch up in Loganville for the project y'all approved last month. We're in the process of constructing that fiber, and we're installing the switch. And while we're doing this, we're gathering data, and we're going to use the same process we used to do the fire hydrants, all of the manholes and that with our staff, GIS all of our splices between here and Loganville, use it as a test, and then we'll probably do the whole system. That's what I had, unless y'all have any questions.
Mayor, if I can add, just Brian touched on the T project. I got an email this afternoon, and Keck and Wood received the executed agreements from Vertical Earth, as Brian mentioned, which is going to be the contractor for the project. So really, just a brief update, they'll be sending those contracts to us to execute, and then those contracts will then go to DOT for execution on their behalf. Scheduled to have a pre-construction meeting sometime mid-late this month, and after that, work should begin a week or two after the pre-construction meeting. So we're looking at 1st of September,
okay.
Just as a FYI.
Very good.
You said that we'll have to do our part first on this T project.
Well, I want to do our part first. I want to
be
out of their way.
Okay, I just wanted you to let the citizens know what's the first thing for them to look for, to let them know that the project is beginning.
Well, I think me and Mr. Chance had spoken about that last week. He's talking about getting some signs made say these, you know, your tea project, tax dollars at work. We'll put something on our Facebook page and our website talking about it when we break ground. And it should be Tuesday or Wednesday of next week when that happens.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am, we'll get that information out.
Okay, any other questions for Brian?
Okay, thank you, Brian.
Thank you.
Finance Department.
Thank you, Mayor. On our statistics, they're pretty much in line with how they've been being. Nothing's too far out of whack. The sales tax looks like it's coming in about how we had projected. On the financial status report, all the departments are looking good. They're keeping it pretty much under budget for the most part. A couple in the one to note in gas and the utilities is a little bit over, but that is because of the cost of service for the gas. But the revenue should also be up on that line item. So, and the solid waste, I did want to point that out as well. Revenue is under budget, but also is the expenses under budget in proportion to that. So that's not really a problem there. And I'll point out a couple of things we're working on. They're working on the AMR project, which Beth's working in conjunction with that. We're preparing for the workshop coming up and getting the CIP budget ready. The 2014 digest, we've been doing the prep work for that and getting everything ready. Hope to get the village rate approved in second meeting in September with the bills mailed out soon thereafter. And been working on the clinic transition with Worksite from caregivers. And I'll take any questions you might have.
Okay, no questions. Thank you, Renee. Moving to fire.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. As you can see, we answered 163 calls for service, 114 of them were med assist calls, had 203 phone calls, conducted 359 hours of training. One thing you'll notice that if you go by, I see the fire truck, we've gotten the decals and all the striping is the same now on the fire trucks. They look, you know, the same. Our oldest one looks like our newest one now. Also on the other equipment's been updated. We've done a little bit to the outside on the two front doors. It's got a little different look to it. So get an opportunity, you know, go check that out. But pending your questions on fire.
Okay, we'll move into police.
We had 4,807 calls for service in June. Had 393 court cases, conducted 159 hours of training, arrested 126 adults and 4 juveniles. You can see the community events. And a lot of these community events, we had fire that would participate with us on. When you look at just year-to-date numbers, in June being the middle of the year. Year to date on part two crimes is about 7% down. Part one crime is up 1.23%, and that's mainly due to the homicide that we have made an arrest in, and the person's currently waiting trial. Pending your questions.
Any questions for Chief Glass? Thank you, Chief. Solid waste.
Thank you, Mayor. Our stats are pretty much holding steady. We did have a spike in picking up scrap tires. We up 361 compared to 194 last month. And we have a spike in replacing carts. We're starting our cart replacement and repair program, and some of that spike we've been trying to get some of the old cars off the side of the street. Have any questions?
What are you doing on the carts, Danny? What was the car replacement program?
Well, the older cars, we break the metal down and recycle the metal, and we are looking for a hauler to replace the older cars. Just hadn't found anybody yet. They are number two plastic. They are recyclable, and there's a company that can take the old ones. Right now, we just try to piece it together, put a wheel on it, and put it back out.
Any other questions for Danny? Okay, thank you. Streets and Transportation.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I like a few areas from the report for the month of June. We rented out the community building 5 times. Our fleet management department vehicle equipment shop serviced. We made 128 services through the month. Our street division recently finished paving the top section of Breedlove Drive. We're waiting striping on that. As soon as we get the striping down, we'll build the shoulders, and that will be a complete project. We're about halfway through with the city for the second cutting of the right-of-ways. Our tractors are currently out now, so be able to look for those. This week, we should wrap up our first round of spraying for mosquitoes throughout the entire city. Doing that in the evening hours, if conditions are permittable, that truck will be out spraying for those. So if you see it running through your neighborhood, you'll know. Steer clear from it. Don't need to get too close to that truck. Our sign and marking division and building maintenance continue to work on stuff as it comes in and get it out just as fast as it comes in. I'll be glad to take any questions.
Jeremiah, I noticed that y'all had done some work on that downed tree in the cemetery.
Yes, sir.
What about the rest of it? You figured out how you're going to get rid of it?
The rest of that tree, it's on private property. And it has been worked up from at the Edward Street side to walking toward the cemetery. If you were walking through that property, a major portion of that tree's already been cut up for firewood. The biggest portion of it hadn't. If that becomes a problem, we can get in there and try to get it out. Helps. I imagine they'll probably cut it up too. They cut everything else up. But we have cleared what was inside the perimeter of the cemetery.
Yeah, that's all right.
Also in the cemetery, you've gotten quotes to clear the fence line. If y'all want to touch on that, Danny and Jeremiah, just some of the few of the project lists that we had out there.
We got a project list of stuff out there, but we know the roadway needs to be repaved. There's a lot of grass in the road that needs to come out. The fence line needs to be cleaned, and we are in the process of getting quotes. We have one currently in that I believe is extremely high. The other ones haven't come in yet. But we got a certain project list of certain things we're going on. It was recently surveyed, the cemetery was, to see exactly where the boundaries of the cemetery was. So we have a couple of issues that we have to address with that. But it's a work in progress to get that back to where it needs to be.
Is that fence line the one where the tree kind of straddles?
That's one side of it.
The other side would be going.
The chain link runs all the way from Madison back toward Ford Street, parallel with Ford to Spring Street.
Gotcha.
Any other questions for Jeremiah? Okay, thank you. Water, sewer, and gas, Mr. Rodney.
Thank you, Mayor. Nothing really big as far as the numbers go. You do see an increase in our water production. We average 2.7 a day. That's due to warmer temperatures. You also notice down in the water distribution, leaks repaired, a large increase there at 33. That's also due to the weather change, warmer temperatures, caused our ground movement. So we can see an increase in the winter and then also in the summer. Our leaks. Everything else is pretty much normal. Nothing out of the ordinary. I do want to let you know too that the water meter project's going good. currently have about 1,000 meters installed. Had very, very few problems. Name what, less than 10 probably. Just by some really minor stuff, everything seems to be going good there. Our CDC 2013 project, the kickoff meeting's coming up August the 19th. So we'll be getting that one ready to bid out. That's going to replace the sewer on Hubbard, Indian Creek, Wilkins, Hammond, Landers, Cherokee, in that area. And also Mr. Trump Main from Hammond Drive out to South Tower 78 for the bank project. So gets that done. That's pretty much it. If you have any questions, we're happy to answer.
Have you had a first reading on any of the new water replacement, water meter replacement?
First reading and billing.
Yes, we have had a few. We've had probably three, the first two or three routes we have been read. We did see a slight increase. We pulled meters out. They're 63 years old. That's the oldest meter we pulled out so far. And seem to have a lot of them. So the difference as far as bills, we're seeing about 1,000 gallons difference. We've had a few that's been two or three, but most of them on average have been about 1,000 gallons a month. As far as first reading.
How many total meters do we have?
We've got 1,000 in so far. The project's 7,000.
7,000.
Okay, any other questions? Thank you, Rodney. That ends our department reports. We'll move into committee information, finance.
Thank you, Mayor. We have one item on the agenda, and that's we want to discuss the millage rate so we can advertise this break.
Attached is a copy of the PT form, which computes the millage rate rollback. And it shows the millage rate, the rollback millage rate to be 8.353. Last year, the 2013 millage rate was 8.470. And also attached is the 5-year history of the levy and shows all the detail on the figures there. So just really just for information purposes at this point, I need to go ahead and run the ad, and then it'll be on the agenda for adoption in September.
Question. On the chart that's got the current digest and 5-year history, in looking at the millage rate, where it's got the gross millage at 10.7, and then the rollback, and then the net, it's 6.01, and in 2013 that was 5.9. So even with the rollback, the net M&O excluding the bond, the millage rate goes up. Is that correct?
Yes, and if you look, the bond millage rate's actually down some, and that has to be calculated according to our debt service, our GO debt service. So we really just start with, and we're not required to start with the rollback rate, which calculates to the 8.353, and then you back off your sales tax rollback, which is the 4.734, and you back off the debt service millage rate. That is not required. We could actually be charging the higher rate, but when the decision was made to issue bonds, they had just said we would back that rate off and not increase the debt or the millage rate. So that decision was made those many years ago. So that's why it's just backed off to get to that 6.017.
Yeah, last year when we were having this discussion, and the bond millage rate had a pretty good increase, not huge, but a pretty good increase, and I don't know why I had in my mind that it was said at that time that that rate would continue to go up.
And it typically does, but because we had an increase in the digest, and if you'll go back and look at the PT form, other changes to taxable digest, there's some $20 million there. That causes the ratio to debt service to the bond, to the millage rate, or the digest rather, it causes that to go up or down. And because we had the increase in the digest, then that portion changed. And the increase in that amount, by the way, is a faded property that was not on the digest for Walmart, and that is 100% on the digest now. And I did verify that with Deary Boyd. So had that not gone on there, it wouldn't have been quite the increase.
So just, and I know I'm asking questions because I don't understand, okay? So you can bear with me for a moment. If we have an increase in the digest, why would we have an increase in the net M&O millage?
It depends on whether it's an increase in the assessment or an increase in additions. So that it's calculated differently. You have to go back to the PT. The reassessment and the other taxable changes, one is disallowed. So, you know, you have growth in the digest and still collect more in taxes, and that's legally allowable. But what's happening is Walmart, which was not on the digest and was being billed out separately, now has switched to the digest. So we're not really collecting more money. If you look at the bottom line, the $179,000 that next net tax increase.
I'm sorry, now where are you on this?
On the 5-year history.
Okay.
If you look at that, we actually collected off the digest over $282,000 from Walmart last year. Well, that now will be appearing on the digest. If you take the difference there, we're collecting less money.
So, when we look at all these numbers, how much are we expected to collect at the current rate, and how much are we expected to collect at the proposed rate here?
If we kept the millage rate the same.
If we kept it the same, how much would we collect? And if we adjust it to what this is saying, how much would we collect?
Well, if you use the millage rate, rollback rate, we'll collect that 2.838. That's if motor vehicles and mobile homes comes in as they're saying. That, of course, is always a variable. Let's see. If we left the millage rate at 8.47, then we would collect 2.877 as opposed to 2.838, which is the...
Renee, this sales, this rollback, less rollbacks, 4.734, that's sales tax projected, or is that what you're talking about?
State law mandates that as well. You have to take actual state sales tax collections from the prior year, and you divide that by the digest.
So that number is based off of really 2013. Mm-hmm. Or sales tax, they should be trending.
That's
up, you think? Yeah, 2014.
Well, and that, of course, it went down because we, there again, the ratio in the millage or the digest changes. You know, when those figures variable, it just changes that way. But that's why that's down. And the sales tax, it was also down. So, you know, it's...
Will you throw those figures out again if they were left the same with the 8.47 and then also the
8.47. It's 2,658,47. if we adopt the rollback rate, it's $2,837,923, which is $179,453 different, which is what's on this five-year ad. Well, the $179,000, that bottom line is what's on the ad.
So the bond millage rate is proposed to come down, but the M&O millage rate is supposed to go up. I'm just...
The total is still the 8.353. That's still the total. You know, I'm not... It's just the way it breaks down as the debt service. If you take the debt service of $787,650 and divide that by the total digest of $337,137, it comes out to the 2.336. I mean, I'll be glad, you know, if you want to sit down and we can go over this figure.
I guess it just throws me a little bit, because last year I know when we had this discussion, and of course at the council meeting, we had a divided vote on it, and the big thing that we were told at that time was it was important that we adopt the rate we did, because otherwise we couldn't meet the debt service bond millage rate because it was going up. But now that we got the bond millage rate going down, the other goes up. So we're not, even though the total net on here is a slight decrease in the millage rate from 2013, I don't know. It's just confusing. I guess I need to have one.
The debt service is up, right?
The debt service is up,
but the millage rate to cover is down.
And the digest is up, and it's just the proportion in which they both rose, the digest rose enough that it lowered the debt service ratio to that.
Our debt service is up, not really due to rate increases, but just different projects we're working on.
The debt service was fixed when we issued the bonds.
Okay.
We need a motion here tonight is to be able to advertise the rollback rate in the legal advertisement in the newspaper so that we can set it in September.
So moved.
Have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Motion second. All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. We'll present this to the council next week. That's all we have this evening, Mayor.
Okay, thank you. Airport, Scott?
Yes, Mr. Mayor, we have one item. Matthew.
Thank you, Ms. Scott. If you'll look at the attachments under this particular agenda item, there's two attachments. One is a scope of services from our airport consultants. The second is a fee that is associated with the scope of services. So basically, the FAA came in and identified some obstructions that we have at the airport. Can't take care of all of those in one lump sum, so we phased this thing out. The first one, and don't let it says land acquisition services. That's not what we're here to approve tonight. It's more of getting this process started. Four tasks associated with this. Basically, the main task is going to be to prioritize or identify and prioritize the obstructions that need to be removed. Now, however, if you read the scope of services, in the future, it could mean either getting easements or it could mean acquiring property near the airport that hold obstructions such as houses, trees, whatnot. So for future reference, we could potentially be doing what we did, 8-10 years ago, and that's acquiring some property to meet these regulations for the Federal Aviation Administration. If you look at the second attachment, that's the fee from our airport consultant of $35,612. Now, of that, we will only be responsible for around $1,700 90% of this will be covered by federal grant money. Another 5% will be covered by state money. So, and then we have that 50% match for the state money, which is $1,700. So that's what I'm asking for approval of tonight, so we can go ahead and get this project started. And I can answer any questions that you may have. And this also relates to another agenda item coming up, which is the the airport grant funds. So I can discuss it there as well. But
I'll make a motion that we approve Matthew to move forward with the construction analysis phase one.
May I have a second?
Second.
Then motion is second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? No. That's all we have, Mr. Mayor. We'll present this next week.
Okay. Thank you. Public Works have anything?
No items, Mr. Mayor.
Okay. Utilities?
Thank you, Mayor. First item is gas marketing, Mr. Middlebrooks.
Thank you, Mr. Several months ago, y'all probably remember Mike Mahalik, the Municipal Gas Authority, came and discussed the marketing plan for our natural gas system. That was the rebates and also the on-bill finance. In that meeting, he mentioned the water heater roundup that takes place in the month of September and October. That's what I'm presenting tonight. It's just another marketing tool, basically for these 2 months. And I'm actually giving you a copy of the website as far as homepage. You can see some of the cities that participate. Basically, what they do for these 2 months, instead of offering a rebate, they actually offer a free 40-gallon gas hot water heater if you convert from propane or electric to natural gas. Now, we're not going to target prime. We're actually going after the Wally MC and our propane customers that we have out in the county where we currently have natural gas lines. As far as expense to the city, the rebate program, you're going to give $200 for a rebate. For this program, hot water heater costs us about $270. Now, with the rebate program, I think we've only had one person. My knowledge is actually taking advantage of the rebates and the on-bill financing. Some of that could be due to a marketing. We sat down with the gas authority and discussed those, and we had a whole new marketing plan. But before we do that, we want to get approval to do the water heater roundup for these 2 months. And then as soon as this is finished up, then we'll release the new marketing program, and it'll be a little more aggressive than what it was last time. With this one, we'll actually go door to door. We've already come up with all the brochures and everything that we'll take with us. But we'll go door to door in the county where the Wally MC and the propane tanks are, and try to get these folks to sign up. One decision that will have to be made, too, is if someone in the city chooses to make us walk from electric gas, would you allow it?
Rodney, don't most of these people in the county that are on propane, they don't even have gas.
When we did the chicken house expansion, Hestertown, Pennell, and Pleasant Valley, we got about 60 to 70 total of all the roads, about 60 or 70 total propane customers. So what we want to do is target those guys because the main's already there.
I was going to say, there's not a lot of people that are going to have gas in front of their house anyway.
Right. Yeah, it's just going to be in those areas. We already have the main. The main's there. Basically, all they need is a tap.
So you're going to have to, to really get something out of it, you're going to be picking off your electric customers eventually, right? No?
But of course, that's why it's not really, I don't anticipate a large number of people doing this, but anybody you pick up as a new customer, it means a total new gas service if they don't have gas already.
Right.
And that involves a tap fee and all of the other things that go along with it.
Right.
Any other questions from Rodney on this? Is there a motion to approve this water heater roundup marketing program?
I make a motion that we approve the heater, the water heater, hot water heater roundup program.
Second.
It's a motion and second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. We will recommend that to council. Next item, Rodney. Oakland Oak Ridge Sewer Pipe.
This is a more of a CIP sewer project. Replace in the CIP we had it for Oak Ridge and Oakland Ridge, both neighborhoods. This year we spent some time in there doing some inspections and I found I've narrowed it down to about 1,700 feet of pipe that needs to be replaced. So the low bid came in $11,052.80. That's consolidated pipe supply. In our CIP budget for the to do the entire neighborhood, it's $141,750. So we'll see the savings in our CIP budget for this project. We're asking to purchase the material we need to go.
Now we're talking about these are all capital projects, right, that we have kind of segregated in our 2014 budget to be done.
Is that sewer line right slap down the middle of the road?
On Oak Ridge, it's just the lower section at the cul-de-sac.
Mm-hmm.
The problem there is the inlet pipe is actually lower than the outgoing pipe. So it causes the sewer to constantly back up the road there. So we'll replace from the cul-de-sac down to the trunk main at the creek. And then on Open Ridge, it starts as soon as you turn in and goes down to the Laura Beach there at the creek. Those are the sections that we identified that something had to be done.
Any other questions? Is there a motion to authorize the purchase of the pipe for this project?
I make the motion that we approve the bid from Consolidated for $11,052.80.
Motion, is there a second?
I'll second.
Motion second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. We'll recommend that to council. Thank you. Next item, Mr. Middlebrooks, the sewer camera.
Thank you, Mr. Miller. This is a replacement of our current camera system purchased in 2001. It's a the one we purchased in 2001 was a trailer unit, so it's all inside of an enclosed trailer. Basically got 13 good years out of it. We reached a point now where we're having a lot of electrical issues. We've got the axle real good on it. We've had trouble with the generator. It's in need of repair. The software is currently no longer supported, and they're looking at anywhere from 40 to 50,000 just to replace the software. So I called Adams and these other companies, had them. We looked at a package that's similar to what we have now. Placed a picture of what we're looking to purchase now. It's actually an ATV unit. We did not go to the enclosed cab, as the picture shows. We did have to save some money. But basically, this is what we use to get our grants. We do all the camera on online. And then we get credit as far as in-kind for our grant job each or every other year. But this new technology, we have the ability to, when we camera a line, we can actually upload that into our mapping system, which would allow us to, when we're planning our CIPs, we can actually, it'll actually grade those lines so that the mapping system would create a list for us. And say, you know, here's the areas that you need to concentrate on. So we've got that feature. And also, in our CDBGs, just normally $20,000 to $30,000 is set aside for just for the camera and the lighting. That's money that we get to city county in kind, so pretty much pay for itself pretty quick. But this is a new technology. It does allow us to get off road, which with the trailer we couldn't. We had to build the road and get into the woods with. That's one reason the Akron event, because when you're trying to get in there, it's pretty difficult to get a 16-foot enclosed trailer back in the woods to video your sewer line. So this would give us the ability to take an off-road vehicle instead of the trailer.
What, Rodney, what do we have right now, you said, in terms of the camera?
It's the same unit, but it's in an enclosed trailer.
Okay.
Now, we would surplus this deal.
And how long does it, I mean, how far can you reach from your trailer now?
1,000 feet.
And this same thing? But you can take this a mile down the road or whatever?
We'll be able to take some of the parts off of the existing one that's still good on it and actually keep those for...
Do you ever cross the tap and go on to private property? And
we can't with this unit, though.
You can't help a resident and charge them, or?
Not with this unit. Now, we do have a portable unit that's available to go down the service lines. We've had that for a number of years. There is a charge for it. We do offer that.
So we already offer that service. If somebody said, hey, come camera my line, and what do you charge them?
It's a minimum of $100. I think it's $2 a foot.
Are we going to lose that if we go to this, or are you going to be able to do it?
No. It's a portable unit.
Oh, okay, you're going to keep that staying on board?
Right. We keep that. The low bid come in from Adams Equipment come in $99,992. Back in April, this unit was actually $98,985, but due to Kubota discontinuing the model, had a new model come out, so we had to get the quotes updated. So that's the reason that the price is a little closer to our budget number.
Is this a smart car?
I'm sorry?
Is this a smart car?
No, it's just an ATV unit. So it's like a little all-terrain, probably driving on the street. We didn't go with the enclosed cab and the AC and the radio and nothing like that.
I mean, how does it pay for itself? Just
from the in-kind stuff we can do with our CDB.
I mean, outside of that, where are we going to?
Well, I mean, we're constantly camera our lines anyway. Anytime you call with a backup, first thing we do is jet the line to stop the backup, but then we go out with the camera to verify what's happened. Is it a root or is it grease or is
so
it?
So you can more pinpoint a problem, and instead of digging up 100 feet of line that really didn't need it?
Well, I just pinpoint the roots, the service lines bad, the lines collapsed. It gives us ability to narrow those down.
Is the lifespan about the same?
Actually, we've done good to get the guy we bought it from, we got as long as we get out of it.
So is he thinking 10 years is probably a good...
Yeah.
So the cost of this is really about $10,000 a year.
The cost of the camera equipment versus the ATV? Or is it just a one package?
It's just a package. I don't know.
I was just wondering if we had another...
Well, we did look at purchasing an ATV unit ourselves, but we've been purchasing what we need to purchase it for.
Really? And we don't have a mule or anything like that?
Kubota is actually the only one they use, because it's actually built with a payload to handle the equipment. It's the only one that has a bed large enough and a payload large enough.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sure this is in our capital improvement budget for the year. And so then I want to ask either Matthew or Renee, are the capital improvement budgets as they're set up, are they meeting the expectations in as far as the transfer of revenue? Do we have the revenue to transfer, and is it going there?
Of the budget, I believe to date, was it June or, I think it was June, we'd only spent about a third to date of what was budgeted, so.
But my question always is when it's budgeted, I want to know if it's, are we meeting budget on the revenue side too?
Coming well under.
Yeah. Are there any other questions for Rodney on the sewer camera unit? Is there a motion?
I make a motion that we approve the purchase of the sewer camera.
It's a motion and second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
We will recommend that to council. Okay, Rodney, you just keep going, huh?
The next item is this is our GIS mapping software. This is just our yearly update, 5550. It's just the yearly upgrade.
Yearly update?
It's usually been under $5,000, and I've been paying for it. Now that it's over $5,000, I'm paying for it.
I move we approve it, Mr. Chair.
It's a motion to approve the software contract. Is there a second? I'll second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. We'll recommend that to council. Stormwater.
This will be my last one. This is a stormwater issue that we've had over between Woodland Road and Plantation. It affects the Witchers, the Smiths, Acox, and the Stasis. If you're familiar with that area. This is we had a surveyor come out and take a look at it. And through their recommendations, we'll be installing 400 foot of 30 inch pipe and 240 foot of 24 inch pipe. Town is currently just an open ditch, and it's causing Mr. Witcher a lot of trouble. It's just about every rain we get is flooding the yard, and it's caused a little bit of damage. So this was the fix for it. Low bid come from Ferguson Waterworks, $11,764.36. That's a little material we'll do the labor.
There has been, you know, we've tried to mitigate this over the course of a couple of years now. Trying different procedures, you know, filling the ditches with rocks, and I don't really know the terminology. But I'm sure Rodney can.
Y'all extended the pipe up for her driveway.
Yeah, that's been.
So you're going down to.
We've got several things.
It's going to make a 90 degree. You're doing more than just that little run.
It's going to start at it'll start on Woodland right next to Tommy Acock's house. It'll go right between his and Stacy's. We'll continue on to Plantation, which would be between Witcher.
That's the one going. That's the big one going down.
Right.
What about her driveway?
If you look across the street where you're talking about, it's that ditch that's kind of.
You know what I'm talking about? You know Faye Witcher's? No, not Faye Witcher.
Miss Bradbury.
This is not Miss Bradbury's.
Okay.
No. Gotcha. Well, this is the bigger problem.
It's in Mr. Purvis's district.
Well, I remember.
I've had people contact me, and I've been over there, and so I definitely recommend we spend this. It's a big issue over there.
Are there any other questions? Do I take that as a motion, Mr. Bradley?
Yes.
I'll second.
I'm sorry.
Motion by Mr. Bradley and second by Ms. Dixon. All those in favor of doing this project? Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? We will recommend that to council. Mr. Thompson.
First item we have on here is for our gang-up electric switch replacement and new placement throughout the system. We have added several of these over the past couple of years, and we are prepared now to, once we finish this project and go on to the T project, as we finish that, this is the next project we want to get on. What these switches allow us to do is isolate outages. Let's say there's a tree down between point A and point B. If we've got switches at either place, we can open those switches, isolate that area, leave everybody else's power on while we correct the problem. Make swapping between substations much easier and quicker. When we had the problem with the substations down on, below the library a couple of months ago with the squirrel, it took us about an hour and a half to swap between stations, where we had all these switches in place, it took about 15 minutes. This is the placement of, out of these 19, 10 of these will be new sites, and 9 of these will be replacement of old single blade switches throughout the system. These will go in conjunction with the work we've done on McDaniel, back around to the next project we're talking about, over to the Davis-Lacey Street area. We're using two providers that have given us basically the same price. One is a Bridges unit, and one is a S&C unit. Both units have been very well vetted by other electric cities, and we've used both of these units in the city for the past couple of years, and they both work fine. Basically, both these guys are giving us the same price, and we're happy with it at this point. I'll take any questions.
Is this what I called you about? This is what I called you about last week.
No, that's another problem. We're going to talk about that next month. Okay. I've got that little problem mitigated until next month, till I get some more quotes in.
Are there any other questions? Is there a motion?
Motion to approve.
Second.
There's a motion and a second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. And we'll recommend that to council next time. CIP reconductors.
Yes, sir. This is the first phase in the capital improvement reconductor for this year. We plan on reconductoring the corridor south of Church Street all the way over to the VFW. We've got the design, as I said a little earlier, we've got the design pretty much finalized. But to start, we need to remove some vegetation. Basically, cut the right-of-way in the entire area back a little further than we do normally. So we can go in and we have to alley out wire. We have to set wire out on the poles a little further out to allow the residents to still have power while we build the new system. And this is, I've had the low bid contractor for ECG over there. He's given me a bid of a little over $14,000, and I'm asking to spend not to exceed $15,000 in case we do run into something we haven't seen. Next month, we will be coming back with the reconductoring part of this project with the wire, poles, and that stuff. This helps on reliability. All that wire down there is number 6 copper. One little small dead end can fall on it, that copper will break and fall to the ground. We've got a lot of that around town, but we've looked at our outages. We have more outages in that area than we do in most. I think we get more of our bang for our buck by fixing that whole spot and then go move on to the next one next year. I'll take any questions.
I want a suggestion I would make. When we do this tree limb cutting and vegetation stuff,
yes, sir.
That once they cut it and it hits the ground, and somebody really cleans it back up off the ground, because that stays there.
Did you have an area you noticed they didn't do it, the contractor didn't do it this year?
McDaniel Street on far end toward St. Ives, that down there.
Well, that was another contractor.
Yeah, however.
We fired that contractor.
Okay.
Yeah.
It just makes a difference, yeah, they don't clean
that
it.
That was actually, we fired them, we hired a company that actually came in a lower bid this year for ECG.
And I would.
Hadn't heard that about them this year.
I just continue to. I would always mention that to them. It needs to be cleaned up and not that junky.
Yes, sir.
And the only other thing is just make sure before they start to work each morning that they're denoting at the intersections of those streets that there's going to be a detour.
Work in that direction. Okay, I'll make it out of there.
Yeah, because I had clients in from out of town and they were rerouted, but they didn't know where to go.
Yes, ma'am.
They were just totally, you know, totally lost.
Lost.
Yeah.
Got it.
Is there a motion to approve the low bid from Burford's Tree Service for clearing this right-of-way?
I'll make that motion, not to exceed $15,000.
Not to exceed $15,000. Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
We will
recommend
that to council. Thank you, Mayor. That's all.
Public safety. We don't have any items, Mayor. All right. Economic development.
Ms. Crossing. She's probably going to comment, but I was going to tell you from a tourism standpoint, we've had two events over the last 2 weeks that have drawn literally thousands of people inside our community and outside into it. So I just throw that out. That's been real encouraging to see that.
Thank you. Yes, we have. We have had great events. I was going to touch on those. We've had a lot of events. Foods in the Mill, referencing the food trucks, having those in town, and then our last concert. And we're having more events that are like Movies at the Mill, where it's private individuals and organizations that are partnering with us. And I really like these because they have a lot more buy-in, there's a lot more volunteers, and they actually take on the majority of the cost of the event. We get to use our network of relationships to market and providing things that we can do as a city. We had incredible help from public safety and from the from Public Works to get that event as successful as it was. So I like doing that. Actually, DDA has approved a community event grant program where they'll help match some of the expenses up to $250 from DDA funds for community events. And so that's to help promote more things like that. There's another outdoor movie this Friday night at the Daniel Tishner House that's very similar. Raising money. Those events have to raise money for downtown development or a local nonprofit. The Moose the Mill raised money for the museum effort. And that is continuing to move forward. DDA actually applied for a tourism grant again this year on behalf of the museum to help develop that tourism product. So that we'll find out in September how if we get that or not. We just turned that in July 31st. And we're very excited about supporting local nonprofits and just seeing more public-private partnership development. A lot of exciting development. Things continue to move forward, I feel like, in downtown and even outside of downtown Monroe. Just wanted to note some of the new businesses that have opened during the summer, Sparrowville Inn, Cotton Cafe, Milo's, they're enjoying a lot of great success. We're very pleased about that. Those little successes, especially with Sparrowville Inn, that's going to be the pathway to us getting bigger things that people have wanted for a long time, like a boutique hotel or lodging. Having successful examples on a smaller scale gets us there. So we're very excited about that, with downtown development, economic development. Also, just wanted to let you guys know, we won a grant last year for the Project Road Share, the bicycling routes, and that kiosk has been installed, and we're happy to share our road signs around town have been installed, and there's an Eagle Scout that's going to be building a brick base to the bottom of that next to the historic city hall over the next 2 months. So that's kind of moving forward. That's going to be a great tourism draw, just walking and cyclists. Continue to encourage that kind of activity in our city. The improvements that are going to happen on North Broad and South Broad, they're going to be bicycle friendly. That's also going to go along towards that. So please, we'll see that happening. The interns have finished their summer internship in the city. They finished this weekend. It was their last weekend with us. A lot of them are going to be coming back for other concerts and events, and one of them is going to be working in after-school programs over the next school year, and a number of them want to live in Monroe once they finish their commitments in Athens and other cities. So that's very exciting, and that's what we were wanting to see happen, was a young generation that's excited about ending up here, at least for the next season. They did a lot of public projects. Hopefully you saw them out working in the city. They completed the picket fence around Pilot Park, so go look at that. It makes that park even more inviting and safe for families and young children. They painted a new mural in the library lobby, and they solicited donations and volunteers and helped, and they raised money for all those projects and did them themselves. So I'm very proud of that program and how it turned out, and they will be missed for all the work they did with the city, but also in all the other places where they helped and served. And they helped put together a master plan for Children's Park that we're going to try to get for the public so we kind of see and get us feedback and ideas. On the area of public engagement, as we've kind of been working on this Monroe Forward and talking about things the city has done, a lot of things we hear is people say, I wish you would do something on Broad Street. I'm like, oh, well, we are. That's actually been in the works for a number of years. a lot of things that we're doing, people just don't know. So Patrice and I have been working on some more creative ways to engage the public and just let them know what has been in the works, what will be happening, and to get more feedback. So we'll be coming for you with some more ways that we want to do that. We're hoping to kind of roll out My Future Monroe campaign, the September concert, just to get more people in the conversation of thinking about future Monroe. I think that's healthy. I think it makes people have hope for the future and kind of gives us a guideline of what's working and what people want. So be happy to answer any questions you might have in any of those areas.
And when is the next meeting of Monroe Forward?
It's August 14th. With the community
team and the staff team. All right, we'll move into items of discussion. We have the first reading of the Airport Commission Ordinance.
Yes, Mayor, that's second reading of the
second reading
of the ordinance, and of course we'll have we'll have to appoint 5 members to that commission. So feel free to email me or whatever ideas. We have 6 names thus far that have been presented to the airport committee, and we'll have those names next week. But we just need 5, so please feel free to email or call.
Okay, and we'll have the approval of the CDBG 2015 grant writing agreement.
And that agreement's with Alan Smith Consulting. They always help us out, and I'll say help us out, but $8,000 agreement with them, I believe, but yeah, $8,000 to get the 15 grant kicked off. So, as you like, you know, Rodney said, we're about to start the 13 grant, the implementation of it, but 15 is coming on board. So,
what's the potential dollar value of that grant? Ballpark, I mean.
Well, we'll get normally get about $500,000.
Okay, I'll just
grant loans, and then we have our part that we in kind of our batch. And that one's going to be the 2015. That'll be the Mill Village. It's going to do 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th Street. Be water and sewer.
And where will that be?
3rd, 4th, 5th, and 6th Street.
Okay, and then we'll have the FY 2015 Airport Grant Fund.
And that goes back to what I was referring to under the Airport Committee item. If you just look at that attachment, basically that's the 50-50 match. And what that is the 5% of that $35,000 is what we'll get back. So right around $1,780, and we'll have to put in the other 5%, $1,780. So this is just us applying to receive those funds.
Okay, we have no other questions. Need a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion by Ms. Malcolm.
Second.
Second by Mr. Little, all in favor. Meeting adjourned.